Today's video is a bit of a niche video. We're going to talk about working with the foot pedal, which is something that medical assistants, transcriptionists, the pharma industry and the medtech industry know well. Even if you're not concerned by this very issue, viewing the video and understanding how to reason will really help you deepen your understanding of posture and how to fix posture issues. I'm really gonna go in the details of the biomechanical reasoning so that, well, this video participates in empowering you to resolve your own problems. I mean, bear in mind that I can be run over by a bus tomorrow, although I try not to. So it's the best is if you develop your own ability to fix your posture. Let's get started by looking at the different type of foot pedals that you have. Basically, we can recognize two families. One family is where the hinge is at the front of the foot pedal, like this one. And the other family has the hinge at the back of the foot pedal. You see that if the hinge is at the front of the foot pedal, you can really keep your heel on the floor and have a micro movement of your toes. You don't need to raise your foot too much. On the other hand, if the hinge is at the back, well, usually the movement, extension movement of the foot is more pronounced, and that can lead to more ankle strain. Some of the pedals have a safety, which is like a cover, plastic cover above the pedal so that it's not activated by accident. For these models, well, your foot will really be stuck into the pedal, so that can also lead to quite some discomfort, especially if the pedal is not at the right place. So unless you have a very good reason to do otherwise, my advice here is try and get a pedal which is hinged at the front. Now, we can also look at what happens sideways. Some pedals will be 2D pedals, so you can tilt, press more on the left or more on the right. That's, for example, for fast forward or backwards. And some of the mechanisms have two pedals. One way or the other, the result will be that you try to move your foot like this sideways and your ankle is really not meant for that. What can we do? Well, this is the moment where we need to discuss about the plan of action. Every plan of action in occupational health is in four steps. Step one, avoid to get there. Avoid to face the problem. Step two, what can you do at technical level? Step three, what can you do at organizational level? Step four, what can you do at behavioral level? So let's be clear on the problem definition. The problem definition is sideways movements of the foot, okay? Whether in rotation or really sideways like this, which will create torsion. How can we avoid get into trouble? Well, it's a good question. I mean, I'm not a transcriptionist myself. What I know is that in every profession, some people use it more than others. So that means that there are always different working styles and maybe you can learn something from each other. But it's not 100% clear to me what you can do to avoid facing this issue. Now we can talk at technical level. At technical level, well, the way out would be, is there an alternative, so another mechanism like a keyboard shortcut or something for fast forward or or rewind. Not sure it's too practical because your two hands are on the keyboard. Then we can talk about organizational level, and that means if you really need to fast forward and things, what is the maximum duration that you can spend before you take a break? And at behavioral level, well, here I would say that has a lot to do with, for example, the type of shoes that you use. I mean, especially I'm thinking if you wear high heel shoes, the dynamics of the ankle is really not the same as if you wear flats. So I would strongly advise that you don't work with pedals going like sideways wearing high heel shoes. But again, this is a very difficult issue and there's no magical solution. So probably step one and two will be a bit theoretical, and what you, where you can actually work is on the organizational factors. Now, the third issue that we have with pedals is where are they placed? And here we need to really review our basics of posture. You see, if my feet are far forward, well, the result will be that I slouch. This is often the problem that we have with pedals. They tend to slide forward. I have here a ridiculous pedal, but that will help us reasoning. You see, if the pedal is far in front of me, on the right side I'll tend to slouch, which will create a slouch and twist it back because it's one side only. And you see, the thing is, this pedal is really running away really quickly. So the idea to fix that is just to put a small piece of anti-slip mat under the pedal, and now it can't move anymore. So I place it where I want it and I use it there. Yeah. By the way, you will see on the picture that this pedal is clearly too thick for me. You see that the basic extension of my ankle is way too much. I mean, I could not work very long like this without having pain, but it's just for the demo. So positioning the pedal front back is super important, but it's also important to position it well sideways. And that means in particular that the pedal should be below my knee. Because if the pedal, I'm exaggerating like crazy, makes me do this, or in the other way, when it makes me do that, again, it affects the shape of my back. Here I'm slouching, here I'm hollowing. So you really want your heel to be under your knee and the pedal to be under the toes, i.e. slightly in front of your knees, but otherwise vertically underneath. The good thing of using a ridiculously high pedal like this one is that you see the problem. You see that my left knee is now higher than my right knee. And that means that my left hip joint is more closed than the right hip joint. Okay? And therefore there's more pressure here than there. And as a result, I want to reopen, especially on the left. So again, having a pedal which is too high will tend to make me slouch there. What you can do sometimes to regain symmetry is put a footrest, or no, this is just a thick book, on the other side, on the static foot, so that at least your 2 feet are the same height. And you see that now, as I've raised the floor somehow, my both hip joints are a bit too close, so I'll have to raise the chair, i.e. sit a bit higher. And obviously, if I sit higher, well, I have to sit higher also with regard to the desk. If we push it a bit forward, well, we can look also at the way organ players play. You see, they play the music with their hands and the bass with their feet. And as a result, the feet go like this all the time, move in every direction. And the result of that is that the legs are unstable, which result in pelvic instability. And this is maybe the last trick that I can give to people who work with the foot pedal, is minimize everything that would make you glide in the chair. It's because you have instability in your feet. So what will make you glide in the chair? Bad ergonomics. For example, if the chair is, you see, leaning forward like this, yeah, if the chair is too much in that direction here, that will make me glide forward. But another thing may just be the type of fabric that I have on the chair. If I have a slippery fabric and I wear like slippery clothes as well, I'm in particular thinking of women's skirts and dress, well, I will be sliding more. So you need, yeah, some kind of friction. And whenever you need more stability, well, of course, the piece of anti-slip tissue that we have put under the pedal could also be used, or a second one could be used under your butt, and that would stabilize you. And this is actually my advice if you play organ. If you play organ, put this small piece of anti-slip under your butt and you will see that it stabilizes you a lot. And once I've done that, well, I will look at the next steps of my action plan. The next steps will be, okay, I'm maybe in a less optimum condition, so the duration between the breaks might be a bit shorter, say 20 minutes instead of 40 minutes. And at the next level, well, the behavioral level says, well, as your pelvis has been a bit more, say, endangered by instability, your lower back may be a bit more tense, and therefore you definitely need to include in your breaks something that will help you relax the lower back. And these are the final stages of the upper body reset, my famous exercise, which you can find here in the description. So to summarize, when you work with the pedal, step number one is you need to make sure that you work with an adequate pedal. And an adequate pedal is one, not too thick, and two, it is, say, stable enough so that you don't need to always have your foot in suspended above the pedal. As far as you can, you should try to avoid the lateral movements, and you should position the pedal in such a way that your heel remains right under your knee. If the pedal is gliding forward, put a small piece of anti-slip. If you have asymmetry, well, you create a footrest on the other side, you raise the chair and therefore you raise the desk. And the last step is you stabilize the pelvis by making sure that it doesn't glide into the chair, that it is well supported by the lumbar support, that the seat pan is not tilting forward, and if necessary, you put another piece of anti-slip fabric in your back. And I very much appreciate your comments and your feedback on all these ideas, because remember, the goal of this channel is to learn from each other's experience.